in it for keepsake. In a field with the cleat lace. Beat freak with the bare face and a slick tie, that's what she say. She look good, she a big tease when she bite lip with the wink face. Hella bad when she throwing it back. She bring out my way for the team play. For Pete's sake, I'm above average, I padded my stack. I gotta matter what he say. I'm the 2010, yeah, LeBron James off the backboard. Type of bad boy, hold it down for the task force. If I run his fade, then you ask for it. Niggas cross, need to laugh more. I keep it 100 on dashboard. The live show need a passport, cause the beat bounced to the cap.
So here we are, guys, out in Perry Stadium as we take on the North Carolina State Wolfpack. It's going to be 1st and 10 at the 30-yard line. Can we win in our season opener? McDonald drops back, throws it to Chrome, and that's going to be an incomplete pass. Not a good way to start off this game. It's going to be 2nd and 10 now. McDonald hands it to Stewart, gets tripped up, and he gets a gain of 2 on that one. It's going to be 3rd and 8. Can we convert here? McDonald rolls to the left, throws across the middle to Stewart, who makes the catch, and that's going to be our first down of the drive. Good catch right there for Stewart. It's going to be 1st and 10. We're spot at the 46. McDonald throws it to Stewart on a screen play, and Stewart gets brought down, a gain of 1. And on 2nd and 9, McDonald rolls to the left, throws it to Stewart, and that's going to be his 3rd consecutive catch, and another 1st down for Bowling Green. 1st and 10, McDonald, stop play right action, there, and McDonald gets sacked on that one. A loss of 6, it's going to be 2nd and 16. McDonald rolls to the right, throws it to Osborne, and they didn't give me the catching animation, but it's going to be 3rd and 16 now. And on 3rd and 16, we're going to throw it to Osborne again across the middle, and that's going to be another incomplete pass. We're going to go 3 and out. It's going to be 1st and 10 for North Carolina State. Morris hands it to Houston, and he gets a gain of about 4, I want to say. Yeah, it's going to be 2nd and 6. And on 2nd and 6, they're going to hand it to Houston again, and he gets brought down by Anders, a 3-yard gain. It's going to be 3rd and 3. Can we stop him? Morris, play action, trying to throw it to someone, throws it to the right, and that's going to be broken up by Chris Bacon. They're going to go 3 and out. Good defensive stop for Bowling Green. It's going to be 1st and 10 at the 40-yard line. McDonald throws it across the middle to Christian Sims, who makes the catch, and he does get a 1st down. It's going to be 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. We're going to move a man in motion. We'll hand it to Stewart, and he gets met at the line of scrimmage. It's going to be 2nd and 10. McDonald drops back, throws it to Kroom, nearly intercepted, and that's going to be Kroom's 2nd incomplete pass, man. You got to hold on to the ball. 3rd and 10. McDonald rolls to the right, throws it to Broden, and that looks like it was defensive pass interference, but I'm not a ref. We're going to go 3 and out. It's going to be 1st and 10 for North Carolina State. Morris, play action, throws it to Lassane. They do get their first down, but hold up, guys. There is a flag down the field. I believe this is coming back for holding. And yep, it's going to come back for holding. That's going to be a 10-yard penalty. It's going to be 1st and 20. Morris hands it off to Houston. He has open space. He has the blockers. Number 54 is in his way, and he finally gets brought down. That would have been an easy 6 points for North Carolina State. Morris hands it to Houston. Juke move. Breaks a tackle. Breaks another tackle, and he's heading upfield. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And looks like no one's going to catch him. And that's going to be a touchdown for North Carolina State. Man, we were doing so well defensively in their first drive. But after that, I don't know what happened. But that's going to be the end of the first quarter with the score. North Carolina State 7, Bowling Green 0. It's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. As we start the second quarter, we are down by 7. McDonald hands it to Stewart. He gets tripped up, and he gets a gain of about 1. It's going to be 2nd and 9. And on 2nd and 9, McDonald rolls to the left. Throws it to Osborne, and that's going to be an incomplete pass. The defense was there to break that one up. McDonald rolls to the right. Throws it to Osborne once again. He had his hands on it, but he dropped the football. And we're going to go 3 and out, man. Our receivers got to learn to hold on to the football. 1st and 10 now for North Carolina State. Morris, play action. Throws it downfield to Lassain, who makes the catch. He gets the first down and more. Not before finally getting brought down by Bacon. That's going to be 1st and 10, the 22-yard line for the Wolfpack. Morris, play action. Throws across the middle to Lassain, and he gets a gain of about 6 on that play. It's going to be 2nd and 4. Morris drops back. Throws it downfield, trying to go for the end zone. That's going to be an incomplete pass, but hold up, guys. There is a flag down the field. It looks like it's going to come back for holding. It's going to be 2nd and 14. Morris drops back. Throws it to Turtle. I think that's how you pronounce his name, but Bacon was there with the nasty hit. It's going to be 3rd and 12. Morris drops back, trying to find someone. Throws it to Lassain, who makes the catch, but then he drops it. It wouldn't have mattered because he would have stepped out of bounds as soon as he caught it. And now it's going to be 4th down for North Carolina State. This is going to be a 42-yard field goal attempt. The kick is up, nearly blocked. And the kick is good. And now it's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. We are down by 10. We're going to go with the option play. We're going to pitch it to Stewart, who breaks the tackle. And he's finally brought down behind the line of scrimmage. A 6-yard loss. It's going to be 2nd and 16. Man, they just swarmed the quarterback. McDonald rolls to the right. Throws it to Kroom, who makes the catch finally. His first catch of the day. It's going to be 1st and 10 now for Bowling Green. We're at the 44-yard line. McDonald rolls to the right. Throws across the middle to Stewart, and that's going to be an incomplete pass. 2nd and 10. McDonald hands it to Osborne, and he's going to get tackled behind the line of scrimmage. It's going to be 3rd and 12. McDonald drops back, rolls to the left, throws it to Kroom, and I can't get to the football. And thank goodness that's a flag. That's got to be defensive pass interference on the defense. And it's a 15-yard penalty for Battle. It's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. McDonald rolls to the left. He's going to take this one for himself, and he gets the first down. Good job for McDonald. 1st and 10 now. McDonald throws it to Embry, who makes the catch, and he gets a gain of about 3 on that play. It's going to be 2nd and 7. And on 2nd and 7, we're going to go with the option play, and McDonald gets tackled behind the line of scrimmage. It's going to be 3rd and 12. And on 3rd and 12, McDonald rolls to the left, throws across the middle to Osborne, and he can't hold on to it. That's his 2nd time dropping the football. We're going to get set to kick a field goal. The kick is up, and the kick is no good. Man, I have a terrible kicker on my team. But anyway, it's going to be 1st and 10 for North Carolina State. The score is still 10-0. Morris drops back, throws it to his left, and that's going to be an incomplete pass. He got hit as he threw it. It's going to be 2nd and 10 now. We have to hold him off for 22 seconds. Morris throws it, nearly intercepted, but we can't hold on to it. It's going to be 3rd and 10. Morris drops back, trying to find someone. He's finally brought down. They're going to go 3 and out. It's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. McDonald rolls to the right. Throws it downfield for Broden, trying to go for it all. Tipped, and Broden makes the catch, but he runs out of bounds. And that's going to lead to halftime with the score 10-0. It's going to be 1st and 10 for North Carolina State as we start the second half. I really thought Broden was going to score a touchdown before halftime. Morris, play action. Trying to find someone, throws it to Carter, and I thought I got the interception, but Carter was there to make the catch. It's going to be 1st and 10 for North Carolina State at the 44-yard line. Morris hands it to Houston, juke move, and he does get the first down and more. It's going to be another first down for North Carolina State. Morris, play action, throws it downfield, and Lassane was there to make the catch. And that's going to be another touchdown for North Carolina State. I don't know what happened to my safeties on that play. It's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. We're spot at the 31-yard line. We're going to hand off to Stewart, and Stewart gets tackled behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to be a 2-yard loss. It's going to be 2nd and 12. McDonald rolls to the left, throws it to Kroon, who makes the catch, but he takes a nasty hit. But thank goodness he was able to hold on to it. It's going to be 3rd and 1. Can we convert here? All we need is 1 yard. We're going to hand off to Christian Sims, and he gets tackled behind the line of scrimmage, man. Our offense needs to do better. We're going to go 3 and out. It's going to be 1st and 10 for North Carolina State. Morris trying to find someone. Has plenty of space. And it's going to be intercepted by Brand. He has it. He's going to cut off field. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And that's going to be a pick 6 for Bowling Green. Good play for the defense. It's going to be 1st and 10 now for North Carolina State. Morris hands it to Houston. He has open space, and he's at it again. He's going to run in for another touchdown. Just when I thought we was going to come back, Houston steps up and make a huge play. That's his 2nd rushing touchdown of the game. Our defense needs to do better in order to stop this run game. 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. We are down by 17 points. McDonald. Screenplay to Broden, who makes the catch, tries to spin, but takes a nasty hit. We're going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage. It's going to be 2nd and 10. McDonald rolls to the left, throws it to Osborne, who makes the catch, but he drops it. He took a big hit on that one. It's going to be 3rd and 10. And on 3rd and 10, McDonald rolls to the right. Has plenty of time, throws it to Osborne, who makes the catch, and he takes another nasty hit, but he was able to hold on to it. McDonald rolls to the left, cuts back around, and he gets sacked on that play. I don't know what the offensive line was doing. That's going to be a 10-yard loss. It's going to be 2nd and 20. McDonald rolls to the left, throws it downfield to Osborne, tipped and picked by Pitts. And Pitts is going to run upfield. He breaks the tackle. Someone bring this man down. And he has the blockers, and Pitts is on his way to the end zone. And that's going to be North Carolina State's 1st pick 6 of the season. Now it's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green. We are down by 24 now, and I don't think we're going to be able to come back. McDonald, play action.
Stop right
and
there,
he's going to get
Scott.
Sacked on that play. It's going to be 2nd and 17, a 7-yard loss. Direct snap to Stewart. Stewart cuts upfield. Juke move, but he drops the football. I've never seen that happen before. A player breaks a tackle, and then he coughs the football. It's going to be 3rd and 14. This is the last play of the third quarter. McDonald. Rolls to the left, throws it downfield to Osborne, who makes the catch, takes a nasty hit, and that's going to be the end of the third quarter with the score. North Carolina State 31, Bowling Green 7. First and 10 now for Bowling Green after that great catch by Osborne. McDonald rolls to the right, throws it downfield, and it's going to be intercepted by Pitts once again, but they're going to call that a safety. Look at that. I guess he was in, then he stepped out, but now it's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green at the 44-yard line. McDonald rolls to the left. He's going to take off with it, and he does get a 1st down on that play. It's going to be 1st and 10 for Bowling Green at the 42-yard line. McDonald drops back, and he's going to fumble the football, and the defense was there to recover it. I didn't think my season opener would be like this, but we are playing versus North Carolina State. It's going to be 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line for the Wolfpack. Morris hands it to Houston, and he gets tackled at the line of scrimmage by Roberts. It's going to be 2nd and 10. Morris drops back, throws to Tortle, who makes the catch, and he's knocked out of bounds, and they're going to be spotted at the 29-yard line. Morris drops back, throws it to Houston, and he gets brought down, a gain of about 6. Morris hands it to Houston. Juke move. He has open space, and he's going to run this one into the end zone, and that's going to be his 3rd rushing touchdown, a 23-yard touchdown run. But that's going to be at the end of the game, guys, with the score. North Carolina State, 38. Bowling Green, 9. So now we're going to take a look at the play of the game. We have number 3, Jordan Houston, the junior halfback who had 8 carries for 203 yards and 3 rushing touchdowns. He had a great game. He averaged 25 yards per carry. But anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this one. Let's go ahead and take a look at the game stats. So that's going to do it for the ball game, guys. We lost our season opener against the North Carolina State Wolfpack, losing 38-9. NC State had 9 first downs. We had 12. They had 306 total offense. We had 216. They had 11 rushes for 207 yards. We had 17 rushes for negative 22 yards. We need to work on our running game. Through the air, they had 7 completions out of 12 attempts and scored 1 touchdown. We had 14 completions out of 27 attempts. NC State had 99 passing yards. We had 238. They got to our quarterback 6 times in this game. That just goes to show that we need to work on our offensive line, and we only sacked their quarterback once. The Wolfpack were 0 of 3 on 3rd down conversions. We were 3 of 9. The Wolfpack were in the red zone 1 time in this game, only making a field goal. We were in the red zone once as well, but we couldn't come up with anything. We had 3 turnovers in this game. The Wolfpack had 1. We threw 2 interceptions, and North Carolina State threw 1. We had 395 total yards. North Carolina State had 366. And time of possession, we had 12:59. North Carolina State had 7:01. Moving over to individual stats, McDonald had a 111 QB rating. He didn't do so bad today. He had 14 completions out of 27 attempts for 238 yards, no touchdowns, 2 interceptions, and a 51 completion percentage. So here is the problem with Bowling Green. Look at this. No rushing yards to be found. Stewart, he had 0 yards today, averaging 0. And then we have Sims, who had negative 1 yards. Osborne had negative 2. And McDonald had negative 19. But when it comes to receiving, everyone was able to catch the football today. Number 85, Kroom, had 3 receptions for 51 yards. Our halfback, Stewart, had 3 receptions for 33 yards. Tyrone Broden had 3 receptions for 62 yards. Austin Osborne had 3 receptions for 78. Jalen Embry, the freshman redshirt wide receiver, he had 1 reception for 3 yards. And Christian Sims, he had 1 reception for 11. Defensively, Chris Bacon, the senior strong safety, led our team at tackles with 4. Billy Roberts was the only player to record a tackle for loss, which was actually a sack. Our left outside linebacker, Bryce Brand, had a pick, which ended up being a 46-yard pick 6. And Broden recorded a safety. Now, I'm really surprised that that happened, because I could have sworn he caught it in the end zone and then he stepped out. I didn't think it would be called a safety, but that's the first time I've ever seen that happen. Last, our senior kicker, Mason Lawler, missed 2 field goals today. So now, guys, we're going to take a look at the NCAA Players of the Week for Week 1. On offense, we have number 6, Achen, the junior halfback from Texas A&M, as they defeated University of New Mexico 47. He had 22 carries for 133 yards, 5 rushing touchdowns, 3 receptions for 37 yards, and 1 receiving touchdown. Defensively, we have number 4, Allen, the junior redshirt strong safety out of Georgia Tech, as they defeated Jacksonville State 42-17. He had 2 tackles, 2 interceptions, and 2 touchdowns. Looking at the MAC Players of the Week for Week 1, we have number 1, Bester, the senior redshirt halfback out of Miami University, as they defeated Kentucky 31-13. He had 27 carries for 183 yards, 3 rushing touchdowns, 4 receptions for 22 yards, and 1 receiving touchdown. Defensively, we have number 30, Oliver, the junior cornerback out of Buffalo, as they defeated UTEMP 29-24. He had 2 tackles, 2 interceptions, and a fumble recovery. So guys, that game didn't go as planned, but next time we meet, we'll be facing the Missouri Tigers, who are currently 1-0. They have a B overall, a B minus offense, and a B plus defense. So hopefully we can come up with our first win of the season. But anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this one. If you like what you see and you would like to see more, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know how I'm doing down in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.